Right, greetings everybody. Coach Kilburn here with one last review video to try to help you get ready for your industry standard certification in Adobe InDesign CC. Guys, this video is going to be kind of short and it's mostly about master pages and using master pages. Okay, so first of all, what is a master page? Guys, a master page is a non-printing page. Okay, if you open your pages panel, none means there's no master applied, or we can set up things on the A master. Now, if there's an A master, you got to know you can have a B master and a C master. The A master is the daddy or the mommy. The B master is the child, right? The C master is like the little baby doll the child plays with. So think of hierarchy, right? Master A is at the top. Master B would fall under that. Master C would fall under that. But guys, right now, we just set up one master page, right? So guys, look, I'm on my master. My pages panel, I can go to any pages by clicking on those pages in the pages panel. But right now, I'm on my A master, okay? So again, a master page is a non-printing page. If we printed, this page would not print. If we printed right now, we'd print 8 blank documents. So a master page one is a non-printing page, right? When you print, it would not print, okay? It's just up here. All right, so guys, you kind of use a master page. It's kind of like a template for all the rest of your pages. So if you're designing a magazine, right? I have an 8-page magazine here. There are certain elements that I want found on every single page. We call that consistency, right? That's a good design thing, consistency. We don't want all of our pages to have different text boxes, different colors, different images, different fonts, right? We need some consistency. Our viewers like consistency. They want to feel comfortable with our layout and our design, okay? So guys, I set up, for time purposes, I set all this up ahead of time, right? I just made some shapes, right? So on every page, I want this little blue circle with a black stroke and a white W. What does that represent? It's just kind of a logo that represents wildlife in America, right? So I want that element on every page. I also want this text box here that says wildlife in America. I want that on every page. I want an image of a cat. I want a black rectangle so I can maybe put the page number in there or other information, right? I have a couple of content frames here. Each page can have different content, but I want each page to have those two content frames there, right? Under this picture, I want a room for a little caption, right? And then I've got some text frames in the columns, right? And then I've got some content boxes down here. So guys, if I applied this A master to all my pages, all the pages would look exactly like this. Maybe on pages 2 and 3, I put different pictures in here, right? Maybe I change a picture here and I put in the real text. Right now, it's just got placeholder text, right? So let's do that, right? Again, for time purposes, I set up all these elements on this spread. I want every page over here to have the same elements for consistency, and then I can go in and change them up, right? So guys, what I want to do here is I can right click and I can apply master to pages. I want to apply this master to the pages, right? So I'm going to do that now. Right? Two pages. I want all pages, right? Boom. So I'm applying this A master to all these pages. Boom. Now they are, right? So if I come to page one, notice a single page is going to take on the right side of the spread, right? Or the first page. The last page is going to take on the left side of the spread. So guys, remember with spreads, right? Odd numbers are always on the right. Even numbers are always on the left. So think about that. If I go to page one, it's technically a single page, but if you notice in the page panel, it's on the right. All odd numbers are on the right. 1, 3, 5, 7, right? All even numbers are on the left. 2, 4, 6. So that's something for you to know, okay? So I just applied my A master to all my pages. Again, I can come to page 4. I can put different things in these boxes, right? I can change each page, but I wanted to apply this A master, right? Guys, look, with anything, try to right click and you have options. I can insert pages, move pages. I can duplicate this page. I can delete this page, right? I can override all master page items. So maybe I want to override the master page items on that page, right? Guys, numbering and section options, right? Here's where you add page numbers. So on the test, they may tell you to add a page number. So notice how I did that, guys. I just went to the page. So if they tell you to add the page number to page 5, go to page 5, right click, numbering and section options, right? You start at page 5 if you want. Right, they may tell you which style to choose, A, B, C, D, Roman numeral, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So guys, there's different things you can do, right? Guys, also notice every panel has these lines up here. Those have options as well. So try to right click on pages in the pages panel or click on these lines up here. You got a lot of options, okay, a lot of options. So guys, I can create a new master. I have a master A with all those elements. Maybe I want to create a new master. So I can create a new master. It's going to be called master B. If I created another one, it would be called master C, right? You can name it. You can tell it how many number of pages. So maybe you just want to make a master page for a single page. You just go 1, right? All right, so maybe we hit okay. Now up here in our pages panel, we now have a B master, right? So maybe I just take a shape like this and I apply it to the B master, right? Did it add this big black rectangle to all my pages? No, because all of these pages have the A master, right? So let's come to page 1 here. Maybe I want to apply the B master, okay? So what I can do is I can right click. I can go to master options for B master, right? They need you to change something, right? So let's just come to 1 here. Right click, right? Apply master to pages. You can apply A, but in this case, I don't want to apply A. I want to apply B. Hit OK. Boom, it applied the B master. Notice it overrode the A master. Made the B master. Again, I can right click. I can go apply master to pages. Again, maybe I want to go back to the A master. Boom, and it applies it. So guys, with master pages, you need to have your pages panel open. Where do we open all panels? Yes, from window. Go down and open your pages panel, right? You can have no master. You can have an A master. You can have a B master. You can have a C master. You can apply these masters to your pages, right? You can click on a page and right click and you have options. You can come up to these lines and you have options, right? So all that stuff. All right, guys, again, other things about the pages panel, maybe not the master page. Maybe on the test they tell you to swap page 2 and 3. Come to page 2, click on it and drag it over here. See that line that pops up? That tells me it's good to go. Now it flipped the page. So I go to page 2, right? Look, boom. Drag this, drag it over here. See that line? Boom. All right, swap pages. All right, guys. Hopefully that's good enough for you. All right, guys, another thing we can do, maybe we want to add some pages. We have 8 pages, right? I'll click on page 8. Let's go up here to any page. You can go to any page, guys, right? If I want to add some pages, maybe I got 8 pages now, but I want 12. I need to add 4 pages. I can insert pages. They may ask you to do that on the test. I may insert pages. I want 4 pages. I want them to insert after, this case, page 8, but you can go before page, start a document, end a document. Just read the question on the test and do what they're telling you to do. But in this case, I want to add 4 pages after page 8, right? Boom. Now look at my pages panel down here. Okay. It added 4 pages and it applied the master. So watch this. What happens if I undo that? I go back. I want to insert some pages. I'm going to go 4. Right? This time, maybe we'll go at the beginning of the document. Right? Again, it applied the A master. Okay, guys, so maybe what I want to do is apply the B master to this page. Let's see if I can just click and drag it. Wow, look at that. So I've added the B master. See, I'm adding the B master. Boom. See, it's overriding. If I drag the B master on top of the A master, it's going to override that master. Right? But I could come here. I could right click. I could apply master to pages. I could go back and apply the A master. Okay. So guys, make sure you understand the pages panel. Good luck, everybody.